Excuse my dress. My plane was canceled out of Dallas, and I ended up flying to Fort Smith, taking the Greyhound. And I only have my bags here only because of the kindness of an Uber driver. Took me to the airport. So I haven't even checked in. I got to tell you a story. I am not an expert in CRPS. I am not an expert in chronic pain. I am an expert in foot biomechanics. I am a podiatrist. In fact, I've reinvented the entire field of foot biomechanics, and I'm probably the leading expert in the world. The only reason I could say that is I just debated all the top experts in the world at the World Congress, and I wiped the floor with them. And then again at the American College of Foot and Ankle Orthopedic Medicine, and I won that one too. Basically, I didn't win. Isaac Newton did. But I got to tell you a story, something that happened, and why I'm here. I teach all over the world. I give about 50 to 60 lectures a year, every corner of this planet. And I teach wherever they have feet. But I was teaching in Seattle 6 years ago, and this young man walks up to me at the end of my lecture and says, "I came here to see you." I said, "Really? That's nice. Who are you?" He said, "Arik Gohl, G-O-H-L. You may have heard, we just, the Gohl program." So I said, "Massage therapist." I said, "Now I'm intrigued. What are you here for? Why do you want to see me?" He goes, "You make the most aggressive orthotics in the world. I mean, we supply the U.S. Special Forces, the Marines, the Mayo Clinic, Hadassah in Israel. We're all over the world. You make the most aggressive orthotics in the world, and it takes about 3 weeks sometimes to get used to them." He goes, "I get people used to them in 1 day." I said, "Great. Thank you." I said, "Bullshit." But I tried it. He showed me, and I tried it. It was easy. So, and it worked every single time. I was blown away. I begged him. I said, "Please come to Nashville. I want to film you doing this so that I can share it with my customers. And you put it on your website. We'll just put a link in so our customers can learn from you." He said, "All right." I flew him to Nashville on my dime. And at the end of filming, I remembered that I have a rental properties, a few of them, and this young lady that was renting one of my properties, when she was looking at it, she said, "Do you know anything about pediatric RSD?" I said, "As little as anybody." I said, "Why would you ask?" She said, "My daughter has it really bad. She had it in her left knee from a ski injury." I said, "Let me think about it." Well, when I brought him to Nashville after we finished filming, I said, "Would you treat a patient for me?" He said, "Okay, sure. What did she have?" I said, "RSD." He goes, "I never heard of it." I said, "It doesn't matter. Do your magic from here down." Well, his magic is he presses on you as hard as you would press on your own eye. But what I'll go over the science behind it later if you'd like. Bottom line was, he pressed on her gently for 20 minutes. And she stood up, her mouth gaped open, and she turned to her mother. After 4 years of pain level 7 to 10, you know how it is, 7 and it gets worse when it flares. She stood up and said, "Mom, I have no pain." I said, "Gating reflex, it'll be back tomorrow." You know, I'm a skeptical doctor. Typical skeptical doctor. Next day, I called her up. I said, "How's the pain? When did it come back?" She said, "It didn't." Next week, I called her up. When did the pain come back? "It didn't." Next month, I went to collect the rent. I said, "How's the pain?" She said, "It's not there." I was shocked. Then she came to me and said, "By the way, I got a job in Mississippi. I'm leaving. I need out of the lease." I said, "Go. Take it." She moved to Mississippi. I didn't know that she just took the job there. Her family stayed in Tennessee. A year later, I run into her in the grocery store. Her name is Monica DePriest. She doesn't mind I use her name, because you'll get to know her. I said, "Monica, how's your daughter, Haley?" After a year, she goes, "No pain." I said, "Oh, my God. Let me call Arik." Arik's the guy that did it. He's in Seattle. He fell off the face of the earth. I couldn't find him. His Facebook's down, his his clinic's closed, his car is gone, his house is sold, his website's down. I said, oh my God, he must have been hit by a car. And here he is, he cured a case, anecdotal, of RSD. Out of sight, out of mind, 4 years later, I get a text, he invites me to his wedding. I said, you're alive. You have not been abducted by aliens. So what happened was, I said, Arik, you remember that girl that you treated? He goes, yeah, what did she have again? I said, RSD. What is that again? I said, doesn't matter. I'm going to call her up. I called her mother. I said, how's she doing now? She said it was a miracle. It was a miracle. She was told never, ever to play sports. She went out for track. She was 14 when she was treated. She was entering high school. She went out for track, volleyball, basketball, every year. She didn't just go out. She was most valuable player her senior year in volleyball and basketball, went to regionals. I said, what's she doing now? She's on a full basketball scholarship to college. I said, holy moly. They were going to cut her leg off above the knee. It was so bad. And you know how that doesn't work. So I call Arik. I said, Arik, I can't sleep until I know if this was the hand of God, which is possible, or was this a physiological reaction that we could repeat? So I flew him. I said, I put up $6,000, and I flew him up to Nashville. I put him up. I said, I'm going to find patients with this disease. Well, I went to the local pain medicine docs. They told me to go suck an egg. Really? They said, are you kidding me? You want to empty my practice? Not interested. I won't even look. Nothing. I was shocked. I was about to give up. And I went to get my blood drawn for my diabetes. I'm diabetic. And I was telling the phlebotomist the sad story. I can't find anybody with RSD. Do you know anybody with RSD? I couldn't find anybody that was willing to do it for free. It was only a 20-minute trial. She said, why don't you call a support group? Stupid, why didn't I think of that? I call the local support group in Clarksville. They send me 11 patients. I said, all right, Arik, you got 25 minutes. You treated the other one in 20. Let's give you 25. 25 minutes of patients. We couldn't fill up with RSD. We filled it up with fibromyalgia. By the way, everybody with fibro got better. Everybody. But the RSD, three people in a 25-minute treatment went to zero pain. Three. I was doing the happy dance. Four had an average relief of 58% in a single treatment. I'm just telling you observation. You know what science is? Let me tell you what Stephen Hawking says. Science is, the goal of science is to make theory match observation. I'm not giving you a theory. I could if you want. I'd give you my theory, but it's about worth as much as your theory until it's tested. So four people had no effect. We didn't know why. They had multiple surgeries. They had multiple stellate ganglion blocks. They had ketamine, everything you could imagine. Implantable TENS units, you name it. They had everything. So I was doing a happy dance. I was like, oh, Arik, look what you did. Three people are better. This is amazing. Well, the three people stayed better for some of them a week, some of them 2 weeks, some of them a month, you know? And, well, one was a week, one was 2 weeks, and one was a month. There were three of them. So I was pretty excited, and Arik was down in the dumps. I said, what are you so sad about? You help people. And it didn't cost you anything, I paid you. He said, I could have done so much better if you gave me 90 minutes and I could treat him for 5 days in a row. I said, oh, really? You're on. I'll take that bet. I put up $150,000. I pulled it out of my retirement. I haven't gotten a dime back. I don't care. I don't need it. I said, I'm going to fly you. I'm going to pay you an entire year's salary. And I'm going to fly you up to Nashville 1 week every month on my dime. And we're going to find 3 to 5 patients for you to treat. And I'm going to tell you where we are right now. We're now at 61 patients. And 80% are at zero pain. 80%. I wouldn't believe it myself. If you don't believe it, I'll step on your side because I don't believe it. Even though I've seen it now 48 times, people get the zero pain. How long does it last now? We treated people in August of last year that are still ongoing pain-free today. We treated the number one patient advocate for the International Pain Foundation, Twinkle Van Fleet. 17 years of pain levels 7 to 8 and flares to 10. On the fourth day of treatment, and this treatment is so gentle, it's not like physical therapy where you do it and you're in bed for 2 days. As you do it, you get better and better every day. On the fourth treatment, she came out with one of the other patients who was in that treatment group, and they sat down with us outside and said, "We have an announcement to make. We're both completely pain-free." That's been October 1st to now. She is still pain-free. They're both pain-free. So what did we do? I said, look, here's what we're going to do. We're going to videotape right from the first patient. We're going to videotape every single patient before and after every treatment, and we're going to put it up online. We're not going to make any medical claims. We're not your doctor. But, and this is not rocket science. This is the simplest thing in the world. No drugs, no needles, no machines, nothing to buy. And in fact, I'm going to propose something at the end here because I don't need this. I don't need the money. To be honest with you, I own a big factory that manufactures arch supports. I have 100 employees. The bottom line is money is not my issue. So I said, let's make the world better. That's what it's about. So what we've done now is we have a clinic in Nashville. We have one trained therapist, one, who can treat all of 5 patients a week. You know how many people suffer from RSD? Pandemic says it could be, it's 1 million reported, and it could be as much as 10 million people with RSD in this country. And if I did 5 people a week from now until I die, and Arik dies, and he's a lot younger than me, we won't make a scratch in a dent of the number of people. So we need medical professionals to learn how to do it. So we put up a course, and we advertised it to about, I don't know, 30, 40,000 medical professionals. And you know how many signed up for the course? 0. The course is going on tomorrow in Nashville. We're doing it anyway because we're training some of our own therapists because we want more therapists. Meanwhile, I'm getting texts from people in LA saying I'm about to kill myself. I'm on my last nerve. I can't stand this anymore. It's ripping my guts out because I feel personally responsible. So what we're going to do this week is we're going to film the entire treatment. And we're going to put in the actual, it's so easy, it's ridiculous. All you have to do, turns out the ligaments control the muscles. Ligaments, when they're stretched a little bit, they cause pain. When they're stretched a little more, when they stretch a little bit, they don't cause pain. They actually cause the firing of muscles to keep you balanced. There's 900 ligaments in the human body, 214 are in the feet. And another more than that in the hand. What he discovered was if you put the ligament in a relaxed position, if I was working on his arm, let's say I was working on his arm, and I was working on his pectoralis muscle here, right? And that's where his pain was. I would take his arm, pectoralis does this. So I would take his arm and bring it all the way into its most relaxed position of the ligament, right? And then I would have him push very gently, a little more than a thought, against my hand. And that caught, no, less than that. That causes antagonistic inhibition. So the pec is inhibited. While it's inhibited, I would press with the pressure you put on your own eye on his acromioclavicular ligament for about 10 seconds. And here he goes, he's relaxing. What happens is his pectoralis, if I had him lying on the table, you would see it drop an inch, physically drop an inch. This was based on a 1920 technique in chiropractic, Logan Basic. Logan Basic is putting the pressure you'd put on your own eye on the sacrotuberous ligament, which is between the butt cheeks. They affectionately call it brown thumb. And you put this gentle pressure on, and the paravertebrals on the same side go into a profound numbness. But when I saw that profound numbness, I said, this is more than numbness. More than, not numbness, a profound relaxation. This is more than relaxation. You rebooted the muscle. You erased the entire history of trauma from that muscle, period. That's how easy it is. It's not rocket science. It's easy. Are you the caregiver? Are you the caregiver or the patient? You're the patient. Who's the caregiver? Don't have one. So here's what we're going to do. And I have to get approval for this. So I'm going to get in trouble if we don't do it. I am lobbying Arik, because it's his technique, not mine, to put this online, to put this as a video rental, because it's going to cost us a bunch of money to produce the videos. A video rental and make it dirt cheap, dirt cheap. We're charging right now in our clinic, we're charging two. I couldn't find him. His Facebook's down, his clinic's closed, his car is gone, his house is sold, his website's down. I said, oh my God, he must have been hit by a car. And here he is, he cured a case, anecdotal, of RSD. Out of sight, out of mind, 4 years later, I get a text, he invites me to his wedding. I said, you're alive. You have not been abducted by aliens. So what happened was, I said, Arik, you remember that girl that you treated? He goes, yeah, what did she have again? I said, RSD. What is that again? I said, doesn't matter. I'm going to call her up. I called her mother. I said, how's she doing now? She said it was a miracle. A miracle. She was told never, ever to play sports. She went out for track. She was 14 when she was treated. She was entering high school. She went out for track, volleyball, basketball, every year. She didn't just go out. She was most valuable player her senior year in volleyball and basketball, went to regionals. I said, what's she doing now? She's on a full basketball scholarship to college. I said, holy moly. They were going to cut her leg off above the knee. It was so bad. And you know how that doesn't work. So I call Arik. I said, Arik, I can't sleep until I know if this was the hand of God, which is possible, or was this a physiological reaction that we could repeat? So I flew him. I said, I put up $6,000, and I flew him up to Nashville. I put him up. I said, I'm going to find patients with this disease. Well, I went to the local pain medicine docs. They told me to go suck an egg. Really. They said, are you kidding me? You want to empty my practice? Not interested. I won't even look. Nothing. I was shocked. I was about to give up. And I went to get my blood drawn for my diabetes. I'm diabetic. And I was telling the phlebotomist the sad story. I can't find anybody with RSD. Do you know anybody with RSD? I couldn't find anybody that was willing to do it for free. It was only a 20-minute trial. She said, why don't you call a support group? Stupinator. Why didn't I think of that? I called the local support group in Clarksville. They send me 11 patients. I said, all right, Arik, you got 25 minutes. You treated the other one in 20. Let's give you 25. 25 minutes of pain. We couldn't fill up with RSD. We filled it up with fibromyalgia. By the way, everybody with fibro got better. Everybody. But the RSD, three people in a 25-minute treatment went to zero pain. Three. I was doing the happy dance. Four had an average relief of 58% in a single treatment. I'm just telling you observation. You know what science is? Let me tell you what Stephen Hawking says. Science is, the goal of science is to make theory match observation. I'm not giving you a theory. I could if you want. I'd give you my theory, but it's about worth as much as your theory until it's tested. So four people had no effect. We didn't know why. They had multiple surgeries. They had multiple stellate ganglion blocks. They had ketamine, everything you could imagine. Implantable TENS units, you name it. They had everything. So I was doing a happy dance. I was like, oh, Arik, look what you did. Three people are better. This is amazing. Well, the three people stayed better for some of them a week, some of them 2 weeks, some of them a month, you know? And, well, one was a week, one was 2 weeks, and one was a month. There were three of them. So I was pretty excited, and Arik was down in the dumps. I said, what are you so sad about? You help people. And it didn't cost you anything. I paid you. He said, I could have done so much better if you gave me 90 minutes and I could treat him for 5 days in a row. I said, oh, really? You're on. I'll take that bet. I put up $150,000. I pulled it out of my retirement. I haven't gotten a dime back. I don't care. I don't need it. When this, so I said, I'm going to fly you. I'm going to pay you an entire year's salary. And I'm going to fly you up to Nashville 1 week every month on my dime. And we're going to find 3 to 5 patients for you to treat. And I'm going to tell you where we are right now. We're now at 61 patients. And 80% are at zero pain. 80%. I wouldn't believe it myself. If you don't believe it, I'll step on your side because I don't believe it. Even though I've seen it now 48 times, people get the zero pain. How long does it last now? We treated people in August of last year that are still ongoing pain-free today. We treated the number one patient advocate for the International Pain Foundation, Twinkle Van Fleet. 17 years of pain level 7 to 8 and flares to 10. On the fourth day of treatment, and this treatment is so gentle, it's not like physical therapy where you do it and you're in bed for 2 days. As you do it, you get better and better every day. On the fourth treatment, she came out with one of the other patients who was in that treatment group, and they sat down with us outside and said, we have an announcement to make. We're both completely pain-free. That's been October 1st to now. She is still pain-free. They're both pain-free. So what did we do? I said, look, here's what we're going to do. We're going to videotape right from the first patient. We're going to videotape every single patient before and after every treatment, and we're going to put it up online. We're not going to make any medical claims. We're not your doctor. But, and this is not rocket science. This is the simplest thing in the world. No drugs, no needles, no machines. Nothing to buy, and in fact, I'm going to propose something at the end here, because I don't need this. I don't need the money. To be honest with you, I own a big factory that manufactures arch supports. I have 100 employees. The bottom line is money is not my issue. So I said, let's make the world better. That's what it's about. So What we've done now is we have a clinic in Nashville. We have one trained therapist, one, who can treat all of 5 patients a week. You know how many people suffer from RSD? Pandemic says it could be, it's 1 million reported, and it could be as much as 10 million people with RSD in this country. And if I did 5 people a week from now until I die, and Arik dies, and he's a lot younger than me, we won't make a scratch in a dent of the number of people. So we need medical professionals to learn how to do it. So we put up a course. And we advertised it to about, I don't know, 30, 40,000 medical professionals. And you know how many signed up for the course? Zero. The course is going on tomorrow in Nashville. We're doing it anyway because we're training some of our own therapists because we want more therapists. This, meanwhile, I'm getting texts from people in LA saying I'm about to kill myself. I'm on my last nerve. This, I can't stand this anymore. It's ripping my guts out because I feel personally responsible. So what we're going to do this week is we're going to film the entire treatment. And we're going to put in the actual, it's so easy, it's ridiculous. All you have to do, turns out the ligaments control the muscles. Ligaments, when they're stretched a little bit, they cause pain. When they're stretched a little more, when they stretch a little bit, they don't cause pain. They actually cause the firing of muscles to keep you balanced. There's 900 ligaments in the human body, 214 are in the feet, and another more than that in the hand. What he discovered was if you put the ligament in a relaxed position, if I was working on his arm, let's say I was working on his arm, and I was working on his pectoralis muscle here, right? And that's where his pain was. I would take his arm, pectoralis does this. So I would take his arm and bring it all the way into its most relaxed position of the ligament, right? And then I would have him push very gently, a little more than a thought, against my hand. And that less than that. That causes antagonistic inhibition. So the pec is inhibited. While it's inhibited, I would press with the pressure you put on your own eye on his acromioclavicular ligament for about 10 seconds. And here he goes. He's relaxing. What happens is his pectoralis, if I had him lying on the table, you would see it drop an inch, physically drop an inch. This was based on a 1920 technique in chiropractic, Logan Basic. Logan Basic is putting the pressure you'd put on your own eye on the sacrotuberous ligament, which is between the butt cheeks. They affectionately call it brown thumb. And you put this gentle pressure on, and the paravertebrals on the same side go into a profound numbness. But when I saw that profound numbness, I said, this is more than numbness. More than, not numbness, a profound relaxation. This is more than relaxation. You rebooted the muscle. You erased the entire history of trauma from that muscle, period. That's how easy it is. It's not rocket science. It's easy. Are you the caregiver? Are you the caregiver or the patient? You're the patient. Who's the caregiver? Don't have one. So here's what we're going to do. And I have to get approval for this. So I'm going to get in trouble if we don't do it. I am lobbying Arik, because it's his technique, not mine, to put this online, to put this as a video rental, because it's going to cost us a bunch of money to produce the videos. A video rental and make it dirt cheap, dirt cheap. We're charging, right now in our clinic, we're charging $250 a session for 5 sessions. And we have a waiting list. Get on the waiting list if you want Arik to do it. He'll be back in June. He only comes here every few months. And you can get on, if you jump on it, you can get on the waiting list and have Arik do it. Right now, let me give you some examples. Lady comes in a wheelchair. I said, what would be a success for you? She said, if I could stand for 2 seconds. Second day, she gets up and walks 10 steps. Third day, she walks 40 steps. The fourth day, we couldn't stop her. She was all over the place. She went shopping. The fifth day, she was climbing stairs independently. And there's videos of all of this. You go, if you want to see the videos, write this down. Go to YouTube, go to Goal Program TV, that's our TV channel on YouTube, look up playlists, And you could sit and watch every single patient all through the 5 days before and after every treatment and watch them get to zero. It's pretty crazy. It's insane. I don't believe it myself, and I'm telling you this. Don't believe me, okay? But it works. All I can tell you is it's observation, and it's so incredibly easy that anyone could do it. So how many of you are caregivers? I'm a caregiver. You know what? It's the most frustrating job in the world to watch your spouse, your loved one, your child suffer. Wouldn't you like to be able to do something and do something cheap, non-invasive, no drugs? People get off. This works right through antidepressants, right through opium, right through gabapentin. Unfortunately, we've had very mixed results with ketamine. I'm sorry. Some patients that have had ketamine the day before, I can't get through to, the technique doesn't work. But you'd have to be off ketamine for a little while. Sorry. But bottom line is, we're now at 80%. I'll tell you how we're going to get to 90. Everyone gives us detailed medical history. We're examining those medical histories, finding the contraindications. Through patient selection, we're going to be able to pick and choose those that we know are going to get better, which will make us look good, but unfortunately not help the people that are really, really bad. Now, I'll tell you how bad. We're treating somebody right now that I would have rejected. 43 years of RSD. Got it at age 4. She's now 47. Full body, internal organs. Her husband begged me to put her in the program, begged me. I said, yes, we'll put you in the program. I paid for her to fly in from Portland myself. I'm losing my shirt on this. But I'm the kind of person that will give you the shirt off my back, literally. So bottom line is, I don't care. I don't want to be the richest guy in the graveyard. There's no pockets on funeral gowns. If this is my contribution, that I can take a technique that we accidentally discovered and give it to everybody, because pain medicine docs are not going to listen. Sorry. They're not going to listen. But if you're a medical professional or you just want to take the course, I don't care who you are. This course does not, you don't have to know anything. That ligament is 3 inches long. It's hitting the broad side of a barn. It's so easy to do this that there's no reason why everybody shouldn't be able to do it on their loved one. Please don't charge your loved one. Please don't charge. But the bottom line is, you could watch this 5 or 6 times while you're treating somebody after you get better, and you could start treating people. I don't care. Frankly, this is not about money. It's just not. So that's where we are. I want to open it up for questions, please. Ma'am. No, we went to San Jose 3 weeks ago. We have somebody begging us to come to L.A. right now. We went to L.A. about 3 months ago. We went to Mississippi, to Biloxi to treat a group of people. He will come out if there's 5. You give me 5 people, and if he travels, it's a little more than $1,250 because he's got to pay for his travel. Then it's $1,750. A person. If you got 5 people willing in this area to do it, he'll come to this area and he'll do it. But the technique is easy, and if a month from now we release it on video, why would you spend close to $600? Because when you add your travel to Nashville, you're paying your airfare, your hotel, your meals, your Uber back and forth. We added it up at $600 a treatment when you could do the treatment for probably about, each treatment that he does would be 3 videos, and the videos are going to rent for something like $20. So for $60, you could take a treatment And at the end of five treatments, five full treatments, we're getting 80% better. Now, of the 20% that did not get better, it's not black or white. 20% that didn't get better got enormous improvement. And the improvement stayed in most cases. Now, here's an interesting story. Twinkle, the second day, somebody rolled a heavy chaise lounge over her affected foot. So bad that it went black and blue. You would think that would send you in a flare, wouldn't it? No. No flare at all. Her allodynia was gone by the second day. That is the overreaction to trauma. Her hyperesthesia disappeared. Her foot went from blue to its normal color. Her and swollen to where you could see the tendons in just a few days. And in 4 days, she was at zero pain and has stayed there. That's not bad. Can I explain it? I'll give you my explanation. When a ligament's pulled a little, it causes muscles to contract. Pulled a little more, it causes pain. Pulled more, what it does is it releases cytokines, especially a nasty one called HMGB1, which mediates non-infectious inflammation. So what happens? It puts the nerve on a hair trigger finger. It's super excitable. It sends a message via the C fiber. Two synapses, you can measure it, 3.8 milliseconds, comes back down, twitches the muscle, fires again. It's a positive feedback loop. What he does with his gentle pressure is breaks the positive feedback loop. Does that mean you're better? You're out of pain, but you're not better. Why? You still have to deal with the depression. You still have to deal with the fact that you haven't used your muscles in years. We had a lady 11 years, pain level 6 in her left hand. She walked around like this, protecting her hand from the slightest touch. On the third day, she comes in and says, not only is my pain gone, but I want to show you something. Look at this. She could not move a muscle in her arm in 11 years. And she said, now I could put my bra on. That's wild. And she's still pain-free. She was in October. Has not returned. So is it a cure? Not yet. We're calling it remission. It's remission. But I can get 80% of you in this room in remission. By the way, it works on fibromyalgia, restless leg syndrome, and it works on spinal stenosis, low back pain. In fact, there's only one wire going up and one wire going down. So it doesn't matter what caused your chronic pain. It doesn't matter. You go, well, I'm not exactly like that patient. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what caused it. The lady with 43 years, I called her yesterday. I said, you're just finished your fourth day. How are you feeling? She said, at 43 years at pain level 8 to 10, I am currently at a 2. She's getting her fifth treatment at 3 o'clock today. And then she's staying for the course because she wants to learn how to help others. So the course will be in June and July. It's tomorrow. If you want to go to Tennessee tomorrow, you're welcome. But it'll be in June and July. The course is going to cost $2,000. That's what, because I got to fly this guy up and put him up and everything. So it's going to cost $2,000. We only have a few people taking it. And there are people that we asked to take it. We're paying them to take it because they're going to work for us. But our little clinic is not able to handle this. This disease is bigger than us, bigger than we'll ever be. You know what? This treatment doesn't belong to me. It belongs to you. So I'm going to put it in your hands. Thank you very much.